गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज़'स टॉपिक इज कैंसर। सो एज यू नो, कैंसर इज अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पब्लिक हेल्थ इशू प्रेजेंटली इन आवर कंट्री। सो हाउ कैन वी डिफाइन कैंसर? सो कैंसर मे बी रिगार्डेड एज अ ग्रुप ऑफ डिजीजेस कैरेक्टराइज बाई एन एबनॉर्मल ग्रोथ ऑफ सेल्स और it may be the ability to invade adjacent tissues and even distant organs and eventually death in case of advanced diseases. So what is the burden of this disease? So cancer is one of the leading causes of morbidity and mortality worldwide, with approximately 14 million new cases in 2012, and this is expected to rise by leaps and bounds, round about by 70% in the next 2 decades. Cancer is presently the second leading cause of death globally. Approximately 70% of deaths from cancer occur in the low and middle income countries. So, what is the status of cancer in India? There is an International Agency for Research on Cancer, that is the GloboCan project. It has predicted that India's cancer burden will nearly double in the next 20 years. And the projections indicate that the absolute number of cancer deaths will also rise from about 680,000 to 1.2 million in the same period. So this is an important question asked in the exam. What are the most frequent sites of cancer in men? So, in the given order, the commonest cancer in men is lung, then lip and oral cavities, stomach, colorectum, pharynx. Similarly, in females, the most frequent sites of cancer is breast, cervix, uterus, colorectum, ovary, lip and oral cavity. So, what are the causes of cancer? How can we define the causes of cancer? So it may be due to environmental factors or it may be due to genetic factors. So among environmental factors, we already know that tobacco is one of the leading cause of cancer of lung, larynx, mouth, pharynx, esophagus, bladder, pancreas. Alcohol, excessive intake of alcohol may lead to chronic liver disease and subsequently esophageal and liver cancer. Dietary factors also may precipitate occurrence of cancer, like smoked fish has been found to be related with stomach cancer. Lack of dietary fiber in diet is related to intestinal cancer. High fat diet has been found to be related to breast cancer. Occupational exposures are also important, as we know that few of the chemicals and compounds like benzene, arsenic, cadmium, asbestos, these are all related to occupational cancer. Viruses also cause cancer, like we know that in case of HIV infection, that is AIDS, Kaposi sarcoma may occur. In case of hepatitis B and C infection, it may, in the long term, may lead to hepatocellular carcinoma. Few rare causes of cancer may be due to parasites, like schistosomiasis may lead to bladder cancer. Definitely, customs, habits and lifestyles are also related to cancer, like smoking may lead to lung cancer. And few of the other rare causes like radiation, sunlight, all this may lead to skin cancers. And the second point may be genetic factors. Rare causes of some cancers are related with genetic transmission, one of the examples being retinoblastoma. So now, how to control occurrence of cancer. So we may divide this control part into two parts, primary prevention and secondary prevention. So primary prevention of cancer may be related to control of tobacco and alcohol consumption. So if we can prevent excessive or the consumption of tobacco and alcohol in the community, there may be decrease in the number of lung cancer. Personal hygiene is also another important point. For example, in case of cancer cervix, maintenance of personal hygiene may lead to decrease occurrence of cancer cervix. Radiation may reduce. Special efforts should be made to reduce the amount of radiation, especially medical radiation received by each individual, to a minimum. Occupational exposures. So we should place measures to protect workers from exposure to industrial carcinogens. Immunization is another important point. For example, if we vaccinate our population with hepatitis B vaccine, we may reduce the occurrence of liver cancer. Similarly, in case of cancer cervix, due to human papilloma virus, vaccination may give some benefit. In case of food, drugs and cosmetics, there should be strict control regarding addition of carcinogens to foods, drugs and cosmetics. Air pollution may also reduce occurrence of lung cancer. Treatment of precancerous lesions. So early detection and prompt treatment of the precancerous lesions such as intestinal polyposis, warts, chronic cervicitis becomes one of the cornerstones of cancer prevention. Legislation is also very important. Legislation to control the environmental carcinogens like tobacco, alcohol, air pollution. And last but not the least, cancer education is a very important area in relation to primary prevention of cancer. It should be directed at the high risk groups. Coming to the secondary prevention of cancer, it is mainly based on cancer registration. So cancer registration provides us a base for assessing the magnitude of the problem and for planning the necessary services. So cancer registries are mainly of two types: hospital-based registries and population-based registries. Next point may be early detection of cases may help us in prevention of cancer morbidity and mortality. Cancer screening is the main weapon for early detection of cancer at the pre-invasive, that is in situ or pre-malignant stage. Effective cancer screening programs has been developed for cervical cancer, breast cancer, oral cancers. Next comes treatment facilities should treatment of cancer, that is treatment facilities should be available to all cancer patients. And definitely last but not the least, that is the palliative care of the terminally ill cancer patients. We have to remember that 1/3 of all cancers are preventable. So in relation to the primary prevention regarding cancer education, we should educate our patient regarding the early warning signs or the danger signs of cancer. What are the early warning signs or danger signs of cancer? A lump or hard area in breast, a change in wart or mole, a persistent change in digestive or digestive and bowel habits, a persistent cough or hoarseness of voice, excessive menstrual blood loss or loss of blood outside usual dates, blood loss from any other natural orifices, a swelling or sore that does not get better with time, unexplained loss of weight. So these are the early warning signs or danger signals of cancer, which we should alert to a patient. So next, what is cancer screening? So for the secondary prevention, early detection of cases can be done with the help of cancer screening. So we may define cancer screening as the search for unrecognized malignancy by means of rapidly applied test. So why is cancer screening possible? So in many instances, malignant disease is preceded for a period of months or years by a pre-malignant lesion, removal of which prevents subsequent development of cancer. Most cancers begin as localized lesions, and if found at this stage, a high cure rate is obtainable, and as much as 75% of all cancers occurs in body sites that are accessible. So what are the methods of cancer screening? So it may be mass screening by comprehensive cancer detection examination. That means a rapid clinical examination and examination of one or more body sites by the physician may help us to screen for cancer. Next is the mass screening at single sites. So we may screen for uterine cancer, cervical cancer, breast or lung cancer. And third is the selective screening. That refers to screening of certain cohort of population, like it may be parents women of lower socioeconomic strata, upwards of 35 years, or chronic smokers for lung cancer. So few of the examples of cancer screening for cancer cervix. So it is done with the help of pap smear. Actually, pap smear was popular previously. Now it is mainly done on the basis of the visual inspection based screening tests, such as the visual inspection with 5% acetic acid, visual inspection with magnification, visual inspection post application of Luvox iodine. Next comes screening for breast cancers. The best method is mammography, but the first method which we should encourage is breast self-examination by the patient. Then it may be palpation by a physician. Thermography was done previously. Now the best method is by mammography. So coming to the government initiatives which are in place to fight cancer. So as we already learnt about the registries, cancer registries. So there is the National Cancer Registry Program. Then the national programs are in place. The National Cancer Control Program was first initiated. Then it came under the National Program for Prevention of Cancer, Diabetes, Non-Communicable Diseases. So to learn something about the National Cancer Registry Program, that the NCRP, it was commenced by the ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research, in 1981. The main objectives of this program were to generate reliable data on the magnitude and patterns of cancer. Number two, to undertake epidemiological studies based on results of registry data. Number three, help in designing, planning, monitoring and evaluation of cancer control activities under the National Cancer Control Program. And to develop training programs in cancer registration and epidemiology. So the population-based cancer registries seek to collect data of all new cases of cancer occurring in a well-defined population. Usually the population is that which is resident in a particular geographical area. Whereas the hospital-based cancer registries maintain data on all patients diagnosed and or treated for cancer at a particular facility. The focus of the hospital-based cancer registry is on clinical data and hospital administration. So this map of India is showing the different locations of the population-based registry and the hospital-based registry in different cities of India. So to know something about the National Cancer Control Program, so it was started in 1975-76 with priorities given for equipping the premier cancer hospitals. In 1984-85, the strategy was revised and stress was placed on primary prevention and early detection of cancer cases. In 1990-91, District Cancer Control Program was started in selected districts near the medical college hospitals. In 2001, modified District Cancer Control Program was initiated. In 2004, evaluation of NCCP was done by the National Institute of Health and Family Welfare. In 2005, the program was further revised after evaluation. The regional cancer centers were created, oncology wings were created, and decentralized NGO schemes were initiated. So now the National Cancer Control Program has been merged with the National Program for Prevention of Cancer and Diabetes and other non-communicable diseases. So, it has been launched in about 616 districts presently. So, what activity are being carried out under this program in sub-center, primary health center, community health center and district hospital? So, in sub-center, health promotion for behavior change and counseling is being given. Population-based opportunity screening of common non-communicable disease including cancer is being done. Awareness generation of early warning signs of common cancer and other risk factors of NCD are being done. So in the PSC or in the CSC or in the rural hospital, the activities of the sub-center are being carried out along with that population-based and opportunity screening of three common cancers, oral, breast and cervical cancer by EIA is being done. Identification of early warning signs of common cancer is being targeted. And in district hospital, the previous activity are being carried out along with follow-up chemotherapy in cancer cases, rehabilitation and physiotherapy services. So what are the service components which comes for cancer under the National Program for Cancer and Diabetes and Non-Communicable Disease Control Program? So in medical college, mentoring of district hospitals, early diagnosis and management of cancer is being done. Along with that, training of health personnel, operational research are being carried out. In tertiary cancer center, mentoring of district hospital and outreach activities. Comprehensive cancer care including prevention, early detection, diagnosis, treatment, palliative care and rehabilitation is being recommended. Training of health personnel and operational research is also being carried out. So that was the class on cancer. So students, at least from this class, you should know about the cancer registry programs, the population registry, the hospital-based registry. You should be able to tell the commonest cancer which generally occurred in Indian population. You should be able to tell regarding the causes of cancer. As well as should be able to tell regarding the early warning signs of cancer, and cancer screening is very important. So that also we also expect that you should be able to tell something about the cancer screening. Thank you, students.